Good morning. This is Tonetta, your relationship coach at Speak Your Truth. Of course, Speak Your Truth is the relationship coaching business where I educate and inspire you to speak your truth and be who you are within your relationships. And of course, it always starts with you. I'm pointing to myself. It starts with me. It starts with you as well. So like I said, definitely welcome to this video this morning. I know I've been talking all month long about this month being two different things, Child Abuse Prevention Month, and then, of course, Sexual Assault Awareness Month. So I definitely want to speak more about that, but starting this week, we're going to be talking more about the self-care and, of course, healing and how to try to navigate the waters after those kind of things have occurred, I guess I put it that way. And like I said, I'm a survivor as well, so I can definitely, I know some, a lot of these things, and actually majority of these things on my list that I'll be talking to you all about in these videos, of course, have happened to me, and these are the processes that I had to go through as well. So like I said, I definitely want to welcome you all to this video this morning. Just keep in mind that some of you may be triggered by some of this that's going on that I'm talking about in this video. Hopefully, if you are, you can come back at a later time to, of course, listen and to, of course, learn the information, hear the information. And then, of course, pass it along to somebody else that may want to hear it or may need to hear this kind of information as well. Like I said, this is definitely talking about starting today, talking about healing from any kind of sexual abuse or sexual trauma, I guess I put it that way. So let me go ahead and get into number one. Like I said, this is the first video. This is one of the ways that I, of course, healed as well. And, of course, was working through my processes and that kind of thing. The first thing that I did, of course, was just to realize that I'm in control of my process. And you are in control of your process as well. You don't have to, because there's a million videos talking about getting over things, letting go, all that kind of stuff. Like I said, you don't have to rush your process at all. I don't care when the situation happened. I don't care if you were a kid. Or if you were an adult in college or something like that. Like I said, definitely just take your time. It is your process. Like I said, I can do these videos all day long, but I'm just planting seeds in these videos just to let you all know what kind of process you can go through or what kind of steps you may be able to take in order for you to, of course, start healing and working on your trauma, your sexual abuse trauma, and those kind of things. Like I said, we definitely have to do it on our own time. But just keep in mind that whether you want to stay in bed all day and lay around, that kind of thing, whether you want to get up and exercise or whatever your situation may be, or if you don't want to do anything, you want to look at TV all day or something like that. Like I said, it does not matter. If you don't want to have sex at all at this present point, you don't have to. You want to take a shower, go ahead and get that done as well. And go ahead, eat your food and that kind of thing. Like I said, definitely take your time with this. like I said, that's the best thing that I can tell you. But just to let you know that you're in control of your process, it does not matter what other gurus or even myself as a coach will be talking about these upcoming weeks. About healing and forgiving and all those kind of things. But like I said, we definitely have to get to a point where we understand that, of course, whether the abuse happened to us or the sexual trauma has happened to us, it is our body, it's our mind, it's our whatever, I guess, like our whole being. And it's our choice to, of course, go through this process. It's our choice to, of course, decide when to start this process. It's not anybody else's, regardless of what I talk about, like I said, in these videos, or you may hear other places as well. So let's keep that in mind. Like I said, you are in control of your life and you are in control of your healing journey, your path, and that kind of thing as well. So keep that in mind, y'all. Like I said, that was the main thing that I want to talk to you all about in this video. I know this video is definitely very short, but like I said, if you know somebody that has been through sexual abuse or sexual trauma, make sure that you're sharing this video out with them, of course, as well. Sharing it with your tribe, your family, your friends, and those kind of things. And please feel free to comment down below and like and share. I mean, like the video as well. I'm sorry, y'all. But like I said, definitely make sure that you're sharing it as well. But like I said, just keep in mind that after you've been sexually abused or traumatized, that kind of thing, no matter how long it's been, at some point, whenever you feel ready, you, of course, take that leap, take that step to go ahead and go into like the next part of your process and all those kind of things. Like I said, we'll talk about those in the videos to come. But like I said, just to definitely check back here daily to, of course, see the daily video, to see what I'm talking about, to see what's going on, to see what part of the process I'm in and that kind of thing, and to see what part of the process I'm talking about. So with that, I want to say thank you all again for tuning into this video. Again, I'm Tonetta Clay, your relationship coach here at Speak Your Truth. And of course, at Speak Your Truth, I inspire and educate you to, of course, learn how to be who you are and speak your own truth in your relationship. So with that, I want to say take care, everybody. I hope everybody have a great day. Bye-bye, y'all.